am happy to welcome Rabbi Shira Stutman.
My pleasure.
This is quite breathtaking. So I want to tell you a story. And it's about a sixth and I-er, a student of mine who I'm going to call Lisa. When she graduated from college, she moved back home here to DC, only to find out that her parents had sold the house and were moving to Florida. So as you can imagine, she felt quite abandoned. And so she did what many well-educated, thinking 20-somethings do nowadays during periods of transition. She got a tattoo in Hebrew. And the tattoo was like, it was like right about here, right under her arm, and it read, Le'olam lo levad, never for all eternity, never alone. So each week in synagogues, we Jews read a series of stories. This week's story, by the way, is about an obnoxious young man named Joseph and his brothers, and the story of a certain multicolored coat. And when we read these stories, we remember, Pew studies notwithstanding, that what has made Judaism survive for 4,000 years is not this aggregate of statistics, but instead individual people's stories, like Joseph's story, like Lisa's story, like the stories of all the amazing women you heard speak before me, like each of your stories in this room. The task of any person who cares about the Jewish community is to care about all of our stories, the stories of religious Jews and Jews of no religion, of the intermarried and the single, of the tattooed and the bacon-eating, of the ambivalent Zionists, of everyone that makes our 21st century Jewish community great. And I need to tell you, it is a great community that we have today. So I want to finish Lisa's story. No, you should clap. Because it is amazing. But before I step off this bima, I just want to, everything is a bima to a rabbi. I just want to talk for 15 more minutes. No, but I just want to finish Lisa's story. Because what Lisa decided to do right after getting her tattoo was to show up at synagogue. And so over the course of the years, she met friends, and then more friends, and then more friends. And these became what she called her DC family. And 2 years ago, this past week, she and her now husband stood under the chuppah in Florida with a dozen of these DC family people who she had met here at synagogue. And these were the people she had prayed with, and she had studied with, and she had gone to Israel with, and she had given tzedakah with, and she had mourned with. The people who she sat with because she loved them, even when, as happens with all families, she actually didn't like them very much. They were her family. We are a family. So when Lisa and her now husband stood up at that chuppah and they raised that kiddush cup to drink, just like Jews have been doing for thousands of years, as she lifted up her arm, you could just see it peeking out right from the dress, Le'olam lo levad, never, ever alone. Thank you, everyone, and thank you to JWI.